So now let's check the effect. As we can see here, of course it's going up. I don't want it to go up. I want to go in this direction. Okay, so we will do this, but first maybe we can, I think, the explosion is a little big. I don't want something to be that much big. Maybe we can do some modification. Maybe I'll make it something like this. The B scale, of course, I'll make this 0.4 plus or minus 0.25. Okay, looks good. Okay, this will give us lots of randomize. Okay, as we can see, some of it will be big, some of the explosion will be very small, and this is what we want. Now let's make the velocity. Let's make a sphere. I want this sphere to be I want this sphere to be same radius for the gun. Maybe something like this. I want it to be almost same radius. Something like this. Okay. 0.2 looks good. I will make it zero again back. Okay. Here is our sphere, if you want to see it. Okay. And let's give it a copy. Let's make a copy to points. I think this will be the sphere. I will take the first one. This is, yeah, no, I will take only one. Okay, because I don't want to have many duplicates. So as we can see here now, we have the three sphere in its place. Okay, but I want this sphere, I want to move it to transform. I wanted to make it a little back, so I will make this transform like this, put it here, and maybe, yeah, something, maybe something like this. We'll see later. Also, I want to give it a velocity. I will, doesn't really matter, maybe anything. Attribute angular point velocity, all will work. Set all is going to work. So I want it to be in the x direction, 0, 0, something like this. So if we see it, yeah, we have to be here to see it. Maybe velocity, maybe, because I must hide. Yeah, yeah, so it's in the opposite direction. I will make it minus maybe 8. So it will be in this direction, as we can see. and then we will make a pop network. Let me say first, let's go inside. First attribute. Okay, I will leave it 500, but I don't want to live much longer. Maybe something like this. Of course, I don't want to see the. Yeah. So as we can see, it's in the direction that I want, but I want it to be like a cube, right? How can we do this? We will simply add inherit velocity. Maybe I will add 6 by 6 by 6. Let us see again. Yeah. Make it 5. Yeah, maybe something like this. So let's see both together. Fireball like this. Maybe fireball will be like this, and this one. So it will cover. So this one will cover, but maybe I wanted to make it much smaller. Maybe I wanted to make it 3 by 3 by 3. Yeah, maybe something like this. And you know what? Maybe I can move it. I can move it like this. So it will cover it. Yeah, as we can see here. Now it can cover all of it. Okay, and thus it's okay, they can keep. Yeah, doesn't really cover all of it, but most of it. So it will make like random. Perfect. Okay. So now let's make a pyro source. I need keep input smoke. I don't need a temperature, just I need the density. Then let's make attribute volume, rasterize attribute. We'll do both, we'll do the density and the velocity. Okay. I will make a velocity blur. Yeah. But I'm not sure why it take it looks a little strange when it looks like this. Let me check something. No, it has a. It's just work fine. Same, it's in the correct direction. Okay. So, anyway, I'll leave it as it is for now. Maybe I will increase it a little more. 0.08, maybe. Or something like this. So, this will be the velocity, and let's do this null out fill. Okay, so we have the velocity here. Okay, let's go back here. Let's get inside here. Now let's add another source volume. Source volume. Volume source. Let's make a merge. Let's add it to it. And it's in the fireball out well. Let's make color V well small. Actually we can simply use one of those smoke like fuel, for example. Don't need a fuel, no temperature, only the velocity. I need the velocity. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, so as we can see now, it's working and it's go in this direction, but of course it need more modification. Maybe we can make this like 2 or 3. Maybe we can make it 5 to make it much stronger. Yeah, it looks perfect. Okay, so I will leave it as one for now, but I need to make some modification. Actually, maybe we can make at the beginning the particle or the B scale or the density is strong, then after a while it started to disappear, so it wouldn't affect it all the way. So it will just affect it on this line, so it doesn't have to push it all this way, you know. It will just push it on this and then it leave it. Okay, this will be more realistic. So there are many ways to do it. First of all, I will change the life expectancy. It will be short. I don't want to be much long. Okay, we can compare it. If I be here and let's stand here and stand here to see. Yeah, perfect. So most of it actually it is inside it, so it will advect by this volume. Actually I can even make it much shorter than this. But yeah, maybe I will make it a little much shorter, maybe 0.7, maybe something like this. Okay, so this is first. Second, we can control the density by age. We will say at scale underscore h equal this parameter will be fit like this. First we will use the h, second we will use channel minimum, then channel maximum, then 1, then 0. Then we will use density equal f at h. Okay. Like this. Of course we have to put here min And here we will make we will make max. So now let's see what we have here so far. So now let's make it maybe something like this. Minimum will be 0 and maximum maybe 0. As we can see now, we can control it. As we can see here, we can now control it. So at the beginning it will be very strong, but after a while it will start it to fade out. It wouldn't be strong like before. Okay, so this is what we need for now. Let's see the result. I hope the result will be good. Stand here. I want to see this. And also I can actually, you know what? We can control the B scale as well. But this will be too much. Yeah, maybe density equal B scale, maybe. Equal at B scale. Make it a little shorter. No, actually the B scale, you know what? I'm not going to put the B scale. I'll leave it as it is for now. Okay. Vector with something like this, so it should affect this. Yeah, it's inside it, so that looks good. So let's test this one. Okay, so let's check it again. Looks good. Now we need to control some stuff in the Pyro solver itself. First of all, maybe we can use the minimal solver. It will fast this process, but it will disable many of this stuff. Okay, let us check it again to see. I think it will was it's the same. It's not even, I don't know, minimal solve is not working here anyway. So maybe it's not working in the Pyro solver, but it's working in the Pyro solver in the sub level. Okay, so let's see. First I need to make it fast. The time scale, I need to make it much faster. The bouncy, actually it depends. I'll leave it I will leave it by default. The flame, I don't want long flame, I want short flame, so it leave like for 2.5 seconds. Even it can be much shorter than this, maybe it can be one. Just 1 second. Then most of it will be just the smoke. Maybe we can emit smoke. Yeah, we're already emitting smoke. Smoke, maybe. Get 5. Again, we have. It looks cool. Looks cool. But I will make it here, I'll make it 2. I want to make it faster at the beginning. Okay. And also I don't want the I don't want this live much longer. One, two. Yeah, I think 2 will be fine. So maybe now we can see it here. Escape back. Put it like this. We need to. We need to see more if we need to make more modification. Flame life, temperature, expansion. Okay, maybe so I make the explosion a little smaller. By the adjustment P scale, I make it 0.3. You can make it even 0.2. It will be good. And maybe since we change it a little more, maybe we can change this one. Maybe make it like this. Yeah. I'll make it 0.1. Save it first. 0.1. This will be very slow, so I will make it 0.2. Yeah, I think that's it. That's good for now. Let's go back. Okay, I made some change here and there. 0.5 for the flame. I changed some, like the diversion. I make it 5. It was 10. So really, it depends on the reference that or the effect is that you want to achieve. Okay. The dissipation maybe I will make it 0.1. Because I want the smoke to remain much longer. Disturbance depend really what the disturbance that you want. I say 25 is good. Maybe you can make it 35 or something. Turbulence, speed okay. I think this looks good. Okay, just maybe we need to hide the resolution. Let's see what the resolution we have here. Of course, it's very low resolution. I'll make it 0.1. And also, there is something I want to do here. I want to make another tick list. We have a tick list here. I will add a tick, and I will name this. This is the HD, and this is the main. Okay, this is the main. This is HD, as we can see. So if we stand here, we are in the main. Let's go to the HD, and maybe we can. Sorry. Yeah, the voxel size. Maybe we can include in the take. I'll make it 0.03 or something like this. At least it should be 0.01. Okay. We don't need a collision because all the smoke going far from the battleship, right? So I think this is most of it. Nothing much really to do here. We don't have here export to make it 16 bit. It's in the pyro solver in the sublevel, not here, unfortunately, as I show you in previous lesson. But maybe we can do something here. Of course, all of this is volumes. Maybe we can volume compress. Maybe I'll make it use 16 bit flow, and also I will make volume resample just to save space. Make it 0.5, and I will choose the velocity, and let's not forget to make all. So all the velocity will be almost, not almost, the half size. Okay. Last but not least, there is something also we can do here. I think we can make a blast. We can take the density, delete non-select. We can make volume blur. And we can connect it here, and we can connect the density here. 0.00, something like this. It will increase the space of the velocity, but maybe we don't need it now, so I will simply just delete it. Delete this one. I will leave it as it is for now. Okay. Just 16 bit will be more than enough. And of course, we'll make a file cache. File cache. Of course, yeah, maybe. Yeah, I'll leave it for now as it is. I will save it, and I will save it, and I catch you in the next lesson.